Hello, I am Speed Demon TS10, or again in a world of trains, I am the original Speed Demon. And today I am going to be redoing the run for the Canadian National and Steam Town of the X10A 464 tank engine with the Steam Town of Matt. With number 47 in the Steamtown paint scheme. So, I don't know what happened the day I tried to live stream this event, but I had constant problems with trying to live stream this, and I don't know if it affected any of my viewers or subscribers of if they got the notification or not of whether or not I was actually live streaming, because the stream kept crashing, but then GeForce crashed, and when the thing was off, I mean, I wasn't even on the game, I logged out of YouTube, I even shut the computer down after applying the updates on GeForce Experience, and I even went back on YouTube on my own channel without logging back in to see that. For some reason, it said I was still live streaming, and I have no idea what the heck is going on. So, whatever the bug, the issue was, I apologize if it caused you to miss the live stream. So like in the stream, we're going to be redoing a commuter run, but we're just going to do the first run up to the summit. So, again, excellent work as always, Steve, on these incredible, most realistic steam locomotives for trains. So, again, I'm just absolutely enjoying, loving each one of these, every one of these engines. So, some of the features, we got the animated bell hammer. Got Steve and Bill figures, and if we look inside, we can actually see a second animated fireman doing the shoveling. And so coal level goes down while in use. And we also have the working, well, it's not a tender, it's bunker light? Backlight? Not sure what would you call that. So, over here we have version 1 of the X10A's, the first early Canadian National paint scheme. And then we also have the later paint scheme. And then we also have a CNN commuter coach. And it has the different viewpoints. And both the CN versions can be renumbered. And then we have number 47 now in Steamtown. And then we got the Steamtown concepts. We got the combine with viewpoints. We also have the coach car. So, something really interesting about these tank engines, they were originally supposed to be, I think, what, 4 6-0s, but then came with a four-wheel tender attachment. And then thus they were become tank engines. And something else that's really interesting, that the front end of the X10A looks like the front of like 3254, the S1B and Mikado. And they also remind me of the, I guess, a similar front end of the K&L Trains' 462 G2 Pacific. Even though I think this one it's a fictional engine made with different parts of other Canadian engines. But even still, with like number 3254 and the X10As, they have really identical front ends, or they look similar. Wonder if that's like why the Greenbriars look like the Canoas, or the so on and so forth. But should be about ready to go here soon. Alright, well, hope you enjoyed today's run, and we'll be making different stops up there, so I'll chit-chat a little bit every now and then. we have reached Fogarty's Inn. Alright, on to the next one. So here we are at the what? Zandan Carvent Kroger, was it Kroger Vid? I have no idea. Okay then, looks like all the passengers are on, so all aboard to the next one. We'll be right back. So here we are. Now we are at Arrows Eye. Arrows Village. I think the only station I was able to pronounce is Fogarty's. Alright, so before we proceed, we gotta wait for another train to pass by. So, yeah, something else interesting about these tank engines. There we go. So, something else about these tank engines, they were used for, fast commuter service. And yeah, these little engines are, well, I'm saying they ain't that little. I think they're about the biggest tank engines out there. I don't know, is there a tank engine bigger than a 464 wheel configurement? But either way, these tank engines certainly do the job as far as the fast commuter work. Ah, here comes the other engine. So like I said, these tank engines look like, to me, they have the same front end as the S1B Mikados. And here comes one now, 3254. Going to the last stop. And I'll talk to you again when we reach there. Thank you. hope y'all enjoyed today's commuter run. And I don't know what keeps causing that. It's like I go into the front view and go to inside view and the camera glitches out where I can't zoom back in as close as I had it. I don't know what keeps causing it, but anyways, once again, thank you, Steve, for creating these incredible, most realistic steam locomotives for trains. And if you would like to get this, if you'd like to get this for your trains, there'll be a link in the description down below to the K&L Trains website. And there'll also be a link in the description down below to the promo video for this engine, as well as the K&L Trains YouTube channel. And if you'd like to help support this channel, help keep these videos going, there'll be a link in the description down below to my Patreon page. Any donation, big or small, even if it's just $1 a month, I'd be very grateful of your generous donation. So, hopefully, as at the moment of being recorded, I am just now one locomotive away, or one locomotive behind on catching up on the videos I've been trying to catch up on. So anyways, I hope you enjoy today's video, and I will talk to you again in the next one.